Among the many glamorous venues that play host to the world's biggest and best yachts, there is one that has remained at the top of the list for years. Portocervo, Sardinia. Stunning scenery and legendary conditions. No one needs persuading to attend. Especially given the yacht club Costa Smeralda's acknowledged reputation for running high quality regattas.
First of all, we are in Portocervo, that I think that is the best place for sailing in the world. It's a fantastic place.
You enjoy it because the scenery is spectacular. The wind is subtle and shifty and tricky, and so when you do well, you feel rewarded by it.
But there is an even simpler reason why the Maxi Rolex Cup is such a big deal. It's the Mediterranean magnet for the world's biggest, fastest, and advanced Grand Prix Maxi races and super yachts. The gathering also includes some of the most elegant yachts in the world.
This is the race that everybody wants to win. It's addictive. You come back because you want some more, and as long as you have the strength to do it, I think I will still be coming back.
But this year was particularly special. An impressive 50-boat fleet for the yacht club's 50th anniversary. There were seven classes in total, including the powerful Supermaxis, the famous Wally class, and everything else in between, from performance cruisers to out-and-out Grand Prix races. In the Maxi and Mini-Maxi racing fleets, Irvine Laidlaw's Highland Fling 11 and Sir Peter Ogden's Jetu each led their classes. In the Mini Maxi Racer cruiser classes, two Italian yachts, Supernica and H2O, dominated their groups too. But the Maxi Yacht Rolex Cup is also a showcase for the very latest and technically advanced super yachts. Here, the 33-metre Maltese yacht Ribel won the Super Maxi class on her first competitive outing. Meanwhile, in the Wally class, the 30-metre Galatea was pushed hard at the front of the fleet, but went on to win overall against an impressively strong field. But the closest racing was in the Maxi 72s, where the fleet locked horns in a bid for their World Championship title. Dieter Schön's Momo was the favourite and quickly confirmed why, as his team built an early points lead. But their rivals were out to ensure that the German crew were not going to have an easy ride. The racing was close. Momo was pushed hard. And while Schön's team did finally win the title, it was by just 1 point.
First, we improved our boat in a lot of details, and then we improved as a team. And this made it possible to win here.
But while winning was the main goal for those taking part, the spectacle and showcase of the world's biggest and best is what keeps bringing competitors and spectators back.